Pravin Jaria of class 11th A from JNV Dindori, and today we'll illustrate this model to find the values of sine and cosine function by using unit circle.
Here we can see that a unit circle is made on the xy plane. Now let's find the values of sine and cosine function by this model. Let us take a point P on unit circle, and then we have to draw a perpendicular on the x-axis. Then length PM is equal to y, which is perpendicular to side OM, and length OM is x. Also, line joining the points O and P makes the hypotenuse of the triangle, which is radius of the unit circle. Here theta is the elevated angle between hypotenuse and base OM. By this triangle we measure sine and cosine function. Here OM upon OP is equal to x upon 1 is equal to x is equal to cos theta. It means x represents the values of cos theta. Also PM upon OP is equal to y upon 1 is equal to sine theta. It means y represents the value of sine theta. Here the point P xy, in which x represents the values of cos theta and y represent sin theta. Now let me move towards our model. Here unit circle is taken on xy plane. The value of x represent cos theta and y axis represent sin theta. When we move this circle at point A, which is at 0 degree, then x coordinate represent the values of cos theta and y coordinate represent the values of sin theta, which means sin 0 degree is equal to 0 and cos 0 degree is equal to 1. Now let us take another point B, xy, which is perpendicular to x-axis and makes an angle of 90 degree with x-axis. Then x coordinate represents the values of cos theta and y-axis represents the values of sin theta, which means cos 90 is equal to 0 and sin 90 degree is equal to 1. And in the same way, we can also find the values of sin 180 degree, which is equal to 0, and cos 180 degree, which is equal to minus 1. Also we can find the value of cos 270 degree, which is equal to 0, and sin 270 degree, which is equal to minus 1. We can also find the value of cos 360 degree, which is equal to 1, and sin 360 degree, which is equal to 0. And by this model we can also find the other trigonometric function for angles which are being multiple of pi by 2.
Have a nice day.